Hey guys, welcome back to another video, and this time I wanted to do a little bit of a chattier video. I don't think I've done this for a while, with the exception of when I do like my keto videos, which, you know, it's more like show and tell, which is what I do here, really. Anyway, I wanted to talk to you guys about my beauty guru pet peeves. What are the things that really irk me when I watch YouTube videos, and why I haven't actually been watching very many of them, or have unsubscribed to so many of the, especially the bigger YouTubers. And I wanted to tell you guys why I don't like them anymore, and why I haven't been on YouTube for a while, because honestly, lately it's been very toxic. I'm like getting notifications on videos about certain like scandals and dramas and whatever, and I'm like, I'm not in here for the drama. I go to YouTube to escape real life drama. I don't want to be involved in any of that shit. Anyway, so let's talk about that. Some of the things that really annoy me, and probably like one of the reasons why I have stayed away from YouTube for a while. I've got a list on my phone. One of them is obsessed product pushing. As you probably know, if you have been following me for a while, I think in the last 1.5 to 2 years, I have been trying to minimize my collection. Granted, I've been buying some new things. However, I've also been letting go of other things. And what made me really think about this, and you probably already guys know, is when I watch the Auntie Hauls of Kimberly Clark. I haven't seen her for a while, to be honest. And now there's like loads of people Auntie Hauling stuff. It's become a trend, and I don't know. I used to make those videos as well, but I feel like, you know what? If it's something that I'm not interested in or I'm not gonna buy, then you're just not gonna see it on here. Granted, I understand that some people do it because there are viewers who ask them, oh, are you interested in buying this, or would you purchase this, or would you purchase that? Which is a good thing, and it keeps you, like, it gives you another person's point of view on why it's not calling out the name, you know? For me, I don't like these YouTubers, and I noticed this on bigger YouTubers, a few of them in particular, who are like, oh, I'm obsessed with this palette. Like, this is my holy grail, whatever, you know? And then next month, they've got a new favorite. I'm like, whoa, girl, slow down. Every month, they've got a new holy grail. They've got a new thing that they're obsessed with. I get it. They get sent a lot of products from companies, and they get to try a lot of new products, but I mean, saying that something is so good and is holy grail status, and it's something that you definitely need to get your hands on, stop whatever it is that you're doing, run out and go and buy this, you know, that's just not going to work with me. I've been trying to practice conscious consumerism, and you know, for somebody to be telling me all the time. And this is why, in the beginning, I have amassed a good collection of makeup. Because, boom, I need that in my life. But I don't. I will live. I will literally live without it. Okay? So, yeah, that annoys me when YouTubers are all about, like, in your face, down your throat, shoving products at you. Especially when they've got affiliate codes, or when they have collaborations or sponsorships, you know. Look, I get it. It's very much like if you are working as a marketing person, which essentially this is what YouTube is, when you're influencing other people, trying to get them to purchase products. But there is a way to do it without literally peddling products onto your, down the throats of your subscribers. Next pet peeve. Okay, that was bulletproof coffee if you were curious. Not wine. not disclosing sponsorship. Yeah. I know that in the UK, and I think here in Australia as well, you are required to disclose whether it is a sponsored video, if it is an ad, if it is in collaboration with a brand. You are required to disclose it. I am not 100% sure if that is the same for the US. I don't think so, because I have seen that a lot of like British bloggers, when they are collaborating or are being sponsored by a company, it would be like right there on the video, on the title, it would say hashtag ad, right? I don't see that on in the US. And what I often see is when you go into their description box, that's the only time that you will know, because it will say at the very, very bottom, if you even bother to read through the whole thing, in partnership with, or thank you for sponsoring this, or stuff like that. And I'm like, just be upfront with it. Look, I have no issues with YouTubers or influencers in general doing sponsored videos. You know why? Because that's how the world works. That's their job, you know? That's like telling somebody, an accountant, for instance, to do your taxes, but you don't want to pay them. You know? Influencers, they're there because they work with brands so that they can promote certain products, as long as they're being honest about what their real experiences with the product. I don't see any reason why that should be a problem. Okay, so I'm like, I don't know, I'm confused. Why are you not telling us this? I also know that for some people, it leaves a bad taste in their mouth when YouTubers sponsor. They feel like the YouTuber is selling out. I don't think so, especially if it's like a product that they've used even way before they became a YouTube star. Like, I've got a lot of products that I've used way before I even started in YouTube, right? And if that company or if that brand approaches me and says, oh, can we work with you on this? I'd be like, hell yeah, because I've tried and tested your product and I know it works for me. It may not work for everybody, but it certainly works for me, so I'm happy to say a few good things about it. Or if it's something that I have actually used and is shit, happy to tell you as well, you know? Okay, so as long I don't have any issues, like I said, with YouTubers doing sponsored videos. What annoys me is when they don't disclose that it is a sponsored video, because I feel that's a little bit deceptive and it's lying by omission. Whether you admit it or not, when something is being sent to you for free or when you are being sponsored or paid to do a certain job, okay, your opinion towards that product or the way you phrase your reviews would be affected by the monetary value or the in-kind value that is being given to you. Admit it or not, it's there. Okay? Another thing that annoys me, and I have this two particular YouTubers in mind. I'm not gonna name who they are, but I used to really love them. Like, I would watch every single video until I realized that, oh, she's posting less and less videos, and whenever she does, it's always a sponsored video. Like I said, I don't mind sponsored videos, but I would also like to see something else. You know, I don't want to only see your sponsored videos. I don't want you to just be pushing products to me. There has to be something else. Like, she used to be talking about like downsizing her life. She used to talk about like how she oh, now you know it's a girl. yeah. So she used to talk about like minimalizing everything and downsizing and all that stuff. And then once in a while she'd put up a video. Okay, where was I before I was rudely interrupted by my SD card running out of space? I think I was talking about sponsored videos and this particular girl who I used to really like. And noticed that she didn't put up any videos unless it was a sponsored video. And I'm like, that girl, I'm not following you anymore. Okay, this one annoys me the most. It's when YouTubers shade other YouTubers and have so much fucking drama. Like I said earlier in the video, I come onto YouTube so that I can escape the drama of real life. I have enough Korean dramas and television series to watch without having to go onto YouTube to see even more drama. That, to be honest, is something that they bring upon themselves. Dude, get a grip. Huh? And if you don't like to watch what other people is doing, and then you're just gonna shade them and then give them some, like, well, spill the tea, don't watch them. I've stopped watching. I used to like watch drama channels like Here for the Tea and what was the other one, John Kukian, until they became dramatic people themselves. So I'm like, no thanks. I think I've got enough toxicity, negativity, and drama in real life. So I don't really need to be involved in that crap anymore. Okay? So I've stopped doing that. I've stopped watching them. I've also noticed that there are some YouTubers who started out like doing beauty videos and then wasn't like getting the views or subscribers that they wanted, and then turned into drama channels. I'm not gonna say who. I'm just gonna say there's a few of them that are like that. Anyway, so I just don't like it. I don't want to be part of that anymore. Too much. Like, also, there's some YouTubers who I find overshare. I know you may be going through a few things in your life, like maybe divorce or moving house or some kind of like legal drama or whatever. I don't need to know that. Some people may, they might really like that, and that's why I don't watch it. Like, I don't need to know why, what's going on with your life, because I've got things that's going on in my life too, so that I don't really need to be involved in yours, to be honest. I'm here to watch your beauty tutorials. I'm here to watch your reviews. I don't need to know about what's going on behind the scenes. And there are some beauty gurus who keep it very, very professional. Like, they, some things may be going on in their lives, but they're not going to tell you about that because they're a beauty channel, you know? They're not a drama channel. They're not, you know what I mean? Yeah, and then finally, I hate it when beauty gurus are dishonest and are, you know, sellouts. I get it. Sponsorships, marketing, influencers, I get it, you know? A little part of me, about this much, wants to get sponsored stuff too. I mean, who doesn't? It's free. but I'm not gonna like compromise my integrity just to do that. And there's one YouTuber in particular that I can think of who, I don't know why a lot of people love this person, but this person really rubs me the wrong way. First, I think her personality, it's out there anyway. Yeah, I think her personality is a little bit too obnoxious and annoying, and loud, and it's just not my cup of tea. Some people like that, I don't. And I find that whenever she collaborates with a brand, there is something wrong with the product. It's like, oh, they use a different manufacturer, so the formulation is different. It shouldn't be, because it's a formula, you know? And formulas, you follow them to the T. And if you follow them to the T, there shouldn't be any discrepancy in the quality of the product, you know? Throwing brands under the bus after they've paid you millions of dollars. Non-disclosure agreements, they exist for a reason, you know. Yeah, like every time, there seems to be an issue with a collaboration. And that just tells me that, you know what, you're probably just like slapping your name onto something so that you can get paid for it. But not really, like when you say that you've been working on a product for 2 or 3 years or whatever, however long it's been, I expect that you would have tested it over and over again. You would have been sent formulas, you would have been sent, like, you know, samples of the product before they come out, so that you are sure that what you're putting your name onto is a good quality product and that you would not be what's the right term? Deceiving your subscribers by telling them that, oh, I have been working on this for like 2 years and this is like the best palette you're ever gonna have. And then it comes onto their door and it's hit or miss. There are lots of duds. Yeah, I think that's just wrong. And until your product is perfect and you are absolutely 100% proud to put your name on it, you shouldn't slap your name on a product. That's what I think, but that's just me, you know? Because I notice that every time she comes out with something, there's always drama following. There's always inconsistencies, there's always issues. And which is why I have never bought anything that has been endorsed or collaborated with by this particular YouTuber. Because I'm not lining her pockets with my hard-earned money just to get a product that, oh, it's a different batch, so it's like the formula's different. That just does not make sense to me. Okay? And those are my top 5 pet peeves on YouTube beauty gurus. So, I can't talk today. Leave me a comment down below in the description box. If you have any pet peeves of beauty gurus, let me know what they are. If you have a pet peeve on me, please let me know so that I can fix it. Subscribe if you haven't already and give me a thumbs up if you like this video. See you next time. Bye.